All right, so Bill, two candidates breaking out, yucking it up in laughter over what could be the most, I would say, the biggest national security breach. Drudge reported that the media pit was cheering as well on that one. To me, that was the most telling moment.
Well, Bernie doesn't care about the emails. Okay, so a lot of Democrats don't care about the emails, right? As they just don't care. Mm-hmm. I think that's accurate. It goes to honesty. So if you are an independent thinker and a voter who really contemplates your choice, you want an honest president, and I would think you would. Mm-hmm. And this email situation is all about honesty. That's what it's about. If the FBI comes in and says, you know what, we lost some this, that, and the other thing, and we have to indict Hillary Clinton, is Bernie going to care then? I don't know. But, you know, that was planned, contrived. And as I said on The Factor last night, the word was out to all the Democratic candidates. Mm-hmm. Do not attack Hillary Clinton. And if you do, the party will turn on you. Mm-hmm. And they did not.
So you think she got a pass last night?
From her fellow debaters, absolutely. Yeah.
Yeah, and I think that that was partially aided by what we knew about how the debate was going to go from Anderson Cooper, who said he didn't want it to be the sparring. I think that there was some sort of underlying, well, who would do the sparring? You know that as the front runner, she would take the brunt of that. So that there were, it was kind of a two-pronged message coming from both the people hosting the debate and, as you're saying, from within the party.
Yeah, I think CNN made an editorial decision to tamp down the email stuff. But what they did that really annoyed me, CNN, was it didn't ask any questions about ISIS and the world blowing up. I mean, and the migrant question in Europe. Mm-hmm. All of this was virtually ignored. Mm-hmm. And was that a editorial decision? Mm-hmm. I mean, I got a lot of mail that said Anderson Cooper did a good job. All right. Well, I'm not going to cheap shot Anderson Cooper. I mean, that's a tough job up there. Mm-hmm. I'd like to have it someday.
There's a hint.
Yeah, you bet it is.
Yeah, watch anyway, it, baby.
But I'm sitting there going, ISIS, the economy. Every one of the Democratic contenders criticized the economy, but they all say we love President Obama. Mm-hmm. Am I missing something here? If the economy is so bad and you have to fix it, what's he been doing for 7 years?
And at the same time, a lot of attacks on Wall Street, some very targeted and specific attacks on capitalism. I mean, Kirsten, I was listening patiently for somebody to tell us how they were going to fix this economy that still is slowing on a daily basis. I mean, Walmart just today said sales growth is going to be flat this year. That's the biggest retailer in the world. I mean, we're still looking at a really tough time for our economy, and it wasn't even a target of conversation last night.
Well, yeah, I think, first of all, I think Anderson Cooper did an overall really good job. And it's true that there are certain things he didn't talk about, but that's going to happen in every debate.
ISIS?
In every debate.
A certain
no,
thing?
I think, look, I'm not, look, it's not going to be
big.
It's not going to be perfect. That's what I'm saying. Every debate, I think you could pick out something that
they didn't
talk about.
I mean, certainly he didn't forget it.
I think they were probably very aware of who their audience was.
And so they were pandering.
And I think they're aware of their audience, who their audience was, and I think that's something that Democrats actually aren't that interested in hearing about.
Well, let's pursue this. So Anderson Cooper's a journalist, and you're telling me, in your opinion, that he's asking questions because he knows who his audience is?
Well, see, this is why I always hate it when you do this. So you always want to know what was motivating somebody.
Yeah.
I don't know. I'm just
putting
it out there that that could be potentially what they did.
As the biggest threat in the world today is virtually ignored by Anderson Cooper.
My follow-up question when Bernie Sanders said that climate change is the biggest national security issue.
And it gets worse, and I'm sorry to dominate.
No, hold on.
It gets worse.
You have such a hard
time. It gets worse in light of the 60 Minutes thing.
But let me finish what I was saying. What I'm saying is I would have followed up to that when he said that about climate change with the ISIS
question. Okay.
Right? Well, I mean, that was the opportunity to say, well, what about
on
ISIS?
Sunday night, Steve Cross, Obama's best friend, pals, all right, eviscerates him on ISIS. Right? That's just 2 days away.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And Anderson, who works for 60 Minutes, he had to do it, forgets to ask him. This has to be explained.